Namo Namaha friends, I am RRK. Welcome or welcome back to my channel where I talk about all things bookish. So today I'm starting a vlog where I'll be reading an entire series over the course of a week or two. I am planning to read the Hathaway series by Lisa Kleypas, which is supposed to be a Victorian era series. Each book covers the story of one Hathaway sibling, and there are five Hathaways and so five books in total. I must confess, when the Bridgerton series happened, I hopped on to the Bridgerton hype train, and during that journey, I read two Bridgerton books and watched the show and jumped off at the earliest stop. Mainly because I detested the first Bridgerton girl, Daphne. She was manipulative and selfish, and I couldn't warm up to her at all. Especially after the controversial scene that anybody who's read the book or watched the show know about, I simply couldn't condone a character such as Daphne. And I generally do not like books where the main characters don't appeal to me. Especially a romance novel where you have to buy into their romantic relationship. Daphne and Simon's relationship was a toxic one, and I seriously wouldn't wish such a kind of relationship on anybody in real or real life. Now, despite my strong reaction to the first book, I had hoped to like the rest of the books in the series. So I started the second one with the eldest brother Anthony in it. And I didn't like him in the show. And I think that colored my opinion of him in the books as well. And I didn't like it as much. Though I did like the story and his romantic interest, Kate, I still could only give the book 2 stars. I also loved Eloise's character in the show. So I kind of was very desperate to read her story. But after getting burned by the first 2 books, I'm not very keen to take this further. Now, you might ask, RRK, why are you ranting about the Bridgerton series when this vlog is supposed to be the Hathaway series? That is because I heard some booktuber, I'm sorry, I don't remember who that is. Nevertheless, I'm just thankful for whoever it is that recommended this series in their video. They said that the Hathaway series is better than the Bridgerton, both in terms of historical accuracy and plot-wise. So I immediately added the series to my TBR and have been trying to read this series ever since. Now, will I like the series? Is it truly better than the Bridgerton's one? Is it worth your time? Is it binge worthy? That's exactly what we are going to find out in this vlog. So grab a cup of any beverage of your choice, chill and stay tuned to this video. We will unpack the series 1 book at a time. Let's get started then, shall we? I read the first book in the Hathaway series, Mine Till Midnight by Lisa Kleypas, and this is an update of the same. Now, you guys know that I went into this series with an explicit need to cleanse myself of the bad taste that Bridgerton series had left on my psyche. And I'm glad to report that I'm very satisfied with the results. At least the first book is much better than the Bridgerton's first book, The Duke and I. But first, let me put out a disclaimer saying that this vlog is not a side-by-side comparison of the Hathaways and the Bridgerton series, mainly because I have completed only 2 of the Bridgerton series books, hence I'm not qualified to comment fairly on that entire series. Secondly, I'm still grateful to the Bridgerton series for introducing me to a whole array of similar books. In a way, it's a trendsetter and nobody can take that away from it. So that clarification done, let's move on to the point of this vlog, the Hathaway series and specifically the first book, Mine Till Midnight. This is the story of Amelia, the first Hathaway sister, and in typical style of such novels, we get the whole star cast introduced. Their eldest and only brother, Leo, who's a drunkard and almost a lost case. A sister named Wynne, who is frail and sickly due to a recent affliction. Then 2 other sisters named Beatrice and Poppy, who have their own quirks and characteristics. Cam Rohan is a Romani of mixed heritage. This is the story of his romance with Amelia. Now let's start with what I liked about this book. Amelia is the eldest sister, just like Daphne in The Duke and I, but thankfully, unlike Daphne, Amelia displays the characteristics expected from an eldest sister. She's selfless to a fault, so much so that she's solely focused on her siblings' welfare rather than finding a stable life for herself. I understand this could be because the Hathaways are orphans, whereas the Bridgertons have a mother and fairly responsible men in their family. But I digress. My point is that I liked Amelia's character. Not to say she doesn't have any faults, she has, but that only makes her more human, and that's a plus in characterization for me. The second thing I liked about this book is Cam Rohan. Who wouldn't fall in love with this character? You must read this book to get a sense of how an adult male should conduct himself, how self-confidence and how self-assurance can be an extremely attractive trait. He is the best eldest brother, father figure, and husband one can hope for. Rich, handsome, and not a prick. Why isn't Cam on every book boyfriend, book husband's list? He is perfection. The third thing I liked was the plot. There was enough intrigue and plot lines to keep the mundane, drab existence of a pre-technology era story going, and I was impressed. I'm constantly surprised to see how people used to keep themselves occupied before the times of TV, social media, etc. How they could be so easy and content with the company of themselves and others. As an author, it must take immense talent to create an interesting story out of that period. Then I liked the comedy timing. Lisa Kleypas writes with a wry and underrated humor that needs time to marinate and work its magic on you. I like characters that don't take themselves too seriously. Wit in writing is an instant sell for me. Now let's come to the reasons why I didn't give this book a 4+ star. So first, and maybe the only point, is insta love. I simply couldn't understand why and how Cam and Amelia fell in love. It was super fast and I couldn't see any logical reason for that. As a teenager, I probably would believe in love at first sight and instant attraction, but as a middle-aged mom, I know that while attraction might be instant, love takes time and nurturing. I could understand why Amelia couldn't resist Cam, duh. But what is the reasoning behind Cam's love for Amelia? Fate? In fact, he chases after Amelia. Even Amelia wonders about the same thing, as is proved by the following quotes. So one time she says, "You are right. I can't imagine why you are willing to take us on." And there's another quote where she says, "Any man who wanted to marry into the Hathaway family after this should be shut away to the institution." So I agree. I still don't understand why Cam was so persistent in taking on the role of the patriarch of the Hathaway family. Is it because he didn't have a family of his own, because he missed his tribe and feeling of community? I'm not sure. The only perceived negative from his end is that he's a Romani and that anybody associated with him will be discriminated against. So kudos to Amelia's characterization though, because she knows that at this point in their lives, Cam is bringing so much more to the relationship than she is, and she's mature enough to acknowledge that. So I admire that maturity these two people have showed in the way they handled their relationships. But I, for one, thought they lacked the chemistry, which is one of the things that I enjoy and expect in romantic novels. Now, I read this book on audio and I realized I must start including ratings for audiobooks as well. Because unlike ebooks or paperbacks, audiobooks have a direct influence on whether we like a book or not, similar to movies or series. So just as we rate the adaptations of movies or series format, we should also start rating the audiobook productions. So following this decision, I gave the audiobook 3 stars. It was okay. We had a female voice and a male voice narrating the story, which I find is ideal considering it's a romance genre where dual perspectives work spectacularly well. I think I should make a video on how I rate my audiobooks, because the rating method will definitely be different from the actual books. So do let me know in the comment section if you would like that video at all. For the novel, I gave 4 stars, and in conclusion, yes, this is an excellent alternative for the Bridgerton series. At least the first book is. I can't wait to continue with the second one in the series, which I believe is Wynne's story. I think there might be some serious pining and slow burn romance involved in that. So I'm extremely excited. Namo Namaha, friends. It's September 5th and I have just finished reading book number 2 in the Hathaway series, Seduce Me at Sunrise. Now, this is the story of Wynne, the fragile, sickly sister, and Mary Penn, the in-house Romani of the Hathaway household. Mary Penn was rescued by the Hathaway's father and was informally adopted by them. Though everybody treats him as a family member, he thinks of himself as a glorified servant and hence works really hard to earn his keep. Wynne and Mary Penn are childhood sweethearts, love at first sight and so on. But Mary Penn feels he doesn't deserve Wynne for reasons that I will not go into right now because they are spoilery. He also struggles with lots of self-esteem issues, which forms the major conflict in the story. Now, I must say, Lisa Kleypas' writing is as usual amazing. It had me entertained throughout. She kept the plot going forward. All that was fine, but I found that the conflict was not solid enough. Also, it dragged a bit in the middle act. Initially, when I was reading the book, I thought I will be giving this book 3 stars. But the last act, it redeemed the entire book for me because it was supremely entertaining, hilarious, and quite emotional. And I really, really liked that. So because of the last act, I hiked the rating by 0.5 star. I especially enjoyed the way Lisa Kleypas sets the next book in her current book. If you see, I have given 3.5 stars for each of the book in the series till now. 3.5 stars is not shabby, but usually I wouldn't read the next book in the series if I have given any book 3 or 3.5 stars. But in this case, I still want to continue with the series because, as I said, Lisa Kleypas already sets the stage for the next book. I'm not sure which sibling features in the next book, but we have already seen the introduction of Leo's romantic interest in this book, and I'm already intrigued. I already want to know how their romantic story will progress. So the way Lisa Kleypas maintains the interest in the reader regarding the next books, that is an amazing talent. We already know the quirks of Beatrice. Beatrice is an animal lover and she seems to be the heart of the family. She is the child of the family and she's so quirky and fun that I obviously want to read about Beatrice. Leo is kind of a black sheep till now in the family, but I'm sure that his story will be amazing. So yes, I want to read Leo's story as well. I do not know anything about Poppy till now. What takes her? What are her characteristics? I do not know as yet from these first 2 books what she brings to the table in the family. But yes, I am very, very eager to continue on with the series. In conclusion, I gave Seduce Me at Sunrise 3.5 stars and I seriously cannot wait to start with the next book. So see you with an update on the next one. Till then, bye. Namo Namaha, friends. I have been quite busy these few days and haven't had the time to record my views on the Hathaway's book series till today. It's September 20th and it's a lot later than the time I had hoped to complete the Hathaway series vlog, but no worries, I have managed to complete all the books in the meantime. So the last portion of this video will be more a sit-in kind of a video than a vlog. I truly have enjoyed the reading experience of the Hathaway series. So let me begin with the 3rd book, Tempt Me at Twilight. So this was the 1st book in the series. I gave a 4-star rating. It was supremely entertaining. I know I gave the first book also 4 stars, but it was more of a 3.5 stars rounded off to a 4 star. But this was the only book that I gave a full 4 stars. This is Poppy, the third sister's story. In the previous books, though, we did get glimpses of Beatrix, the fourth sister, and her quirky character. We were told precious little about Poppy. The only impression I got was that she was of a docile nature with agreeable character. In Tempt Me at Twilight, we continue from where we left off at Wynn's story from the previous book. Poppy and Beatrix are still staying in the Rutledge Hotel in London for their season, and Poppy isn't having much success with acquiring a match. In a freak incident, Poppy catches the eye of Harry Rutledge, the owner of the Rutledge Hotel at which they are staying. And he is a reclusive but genius owner of the Rutledge Hotel. Harry manages to manipulate Poppy into marrying him, and their story starts from there on. Surprisingly, I adored their romance, their marital tensions, resolutions of their problems. It all appealed to me a lot. Lisa Kleypas has a way of making you root for even the most despicable characters. I adored the hotel staff. I could cheer on Poppy doing anything under the sun. She is such a pure soul. I even liked Harry a lot. We do not see much of the other Hathaways in this book because soon after Poppy's marriage, they all return to Hampshire. So in the index of enjoying the madness of Hathaways, this sure rated a little low. Nevertheless, it was a super fun and steamy read. After that, I read Married by Morning, the fourth book in the Hathaway series. So this is Leo, the eldest and only son of the Hathaway's family. His romance with the prim and proper companion for the Hathaway's girls, Miss Catherine Marks. As expected, this was everything I needed and more. This was so delightful that it toppled Tempt Me at Twilight from the first spot. I gave this book a high 4.5 stars and I was not sure what to expect from the next book, especially after being bowled over by this one. As expected, in this novel, Leo, the problematic child in the Hathaway family, takes a turn for the better. Surprisingly displays the charming, adorable man he could have been if Laura hadn't left him. Catherine and Leo's romance was exciting and fast. Leo chases after Cat and she pushes him away repeatedly. Just as Dodger the ferret's obsession with Cat cannot be explained, similarly Leo's affection for Cat cannot be rationalized. But they make an amazing, if not volatile, pair. They also had excellent chemistry and I loved it. Cat's secret was finally revealed, and truly I wouldn't ever have guessed it. It was not at all predictable, and that is one of the reasons why I think I rated this book high. Now, Lisa Kleypas doesn't set up the next book's couple at all in this one, and that's surprising because till now in every subsequent book in the series, we at least got a token introduction of what's to come in the next one. But not so in this one, and that kind of surprised me. So I was wondering if there really is a fifth book featuring Beatrix or not, and I had to go into Goodreads and check if I really have the number of the series correct. So I read the last book in the series, Love in the Afternoon. This is Beatrix's romance with Captain Christopher Phelan. He's a former socialite turned into a war veteran. This book starts with a time jump of about 3 to 5 years. I'm not sure of the exact time frame, but that kind of explains why Beatrix's story was not set up in the previous books. We start off with Beatrix's life, where she has attended 4 seasons and she has now resigned to the fact that she's simply too different from other girls and that it's simply not possible for her to marry a person from the aristocratic class who expect women to behave in a specific manner. So she is too different and she doesn't want to change herself, and she is not able to find a person who can accept her as she is. Not to mention, the guys also feel that she is a bit too weird to take her back home and introduce to their mothers. So that is where we start off with Beatrix living her life in Hampshire. So one day, her friend Prudence gets a letter from Captain Christopher Phelan, who is her suitor and who is currently deputed in Crimea for the war. So that shallow girl, Prudence, she refuses to write back to him. And Beatrix, with her tendency to care for the wounded and the sad, is unable to bear this, as she thinks the least Prudence could do, especially for her suitor, is to spread some cheer via her letters. So Prudence delegates the task of writing this letter to Beatrix, and a proxy letter courtship begins. First half of the book was so good that I thought this will definitely be a high 4.5 stars, and though it might not topple Leo's book, I sure thought that it might be quite close to that, because the letters, their miscommunication, their attraction, everything was so perfect that I flew through this book. But the reason I gave it only 3.5 stars is because of Beatrix herself. Like, when she was a very incomplete character for me. Apart from the fact that she is different, which is harped on constantly, I couldn't see any depth in her. As characters, Amelia, Poppy, Leo had so much more substance and seemed much more human. Despite my small gripe on Beatrix's character, I have zero complaints on the characterization of Christopher. Christopher is a character who has PTSD and he is suffering from a lot of survivor's guilt. Though I cannot speak for the representation here, I think it was done in a very mature and honest way. Also, you cannot stop yourself from loving Christopher's dog. He is an integral part of the story, especially because it's the dog's mention in the letter that forces Beatrix to write back to Christopher. It's quite a few days since I finished the book, so I don't remember what his name is, but I think it's Albert. I could be wrong. It's a sweet but serious romance that's definitely worth a read. So those were my updates of all the 5 books from the Hathaway series by Lisa Kleypas. I'm sure you can tell from the video that I had a gala time reading these books. If I have to rank these books, then obviously Leo's Married by Morning is my favorite amongst all the 5, and it definitely takes the first spot. Poppy's Tempt Me at Twilight takes the next spot. I gave it 4 stars. Then Beatrix's story, Love in the Afternoon, because even though I kind of found Beatrix's character to be incomplete, there were so many elements that definitely puts it at the 3rd spot. Then Amelia's Romance, Mine Till Midnight, which I gave 3.5 stars, and I loved it purely because of Cam, the ultimate alpha, a very protective and super considerate hero. Then finally, Vince's story, Seduce Me at Sunrise, which I gave 3.25 stars. I really have nothing more to add as far as Vince's story is concerned. So that's that. Now, how does it compare with the first Bridgerton books that I did complete? Now, this series is definitely better than those 2 books. But I must say, reading about Beatrix's letter writing, I was for some reason remembering Eloise Bridgerton, and I'm now desperate to read her story. I also want to finish Penelope's story. I want to see how that adorable wallflower of a girl pairs up with Colin Bridgerton, because in this series, Kat was deliberately a wallflower. So there were quite a few elements of that wallflower kind of a girl. So I was reminded of Penelope, and I wanted to read her story. So ironically, the Hathaway series that I read to escape the bad taste of Daphne and Antony's stories in turn made me rethink about reading that popular series. All in all, it was a surprising and fun experience of reading the entire series. Which are your favorite period romance series? If you have recommendations that are similar to the Bridgerton and Hathaway series, let me know in the comment section below. Maybe I can binge read them too. Hope you had fun listening to my rants and reviews on the books I love to hate and hate to love. I will see you with another video next week. Till then, stay safe, happy and healthy. Om Shanti.